Hello viewers, having dealt with the important aspects of time and time management in the first part of the film, in the second part of the film, we now take up the use of a time log for effectively planning time for different managerial activities. This film will also highlight the three major groups of time wasters and outline ways in tackling these. Let us watch the film.
Now, coming to the third dimension, third aspect of time management, taking a time log. So, you please put this chart here. You have to put it like this. Huh? So, for managing time and taking care of the time, that where the time is going, generally management misconception is, or managers generally get deceived by the time, that they keep on thinking that their time is going where they think it is going, where it should be going. It is going somewhere else, but they don't know where the time is going. They think that it is going right to the right direction, but it is not going to the right direction in the real practical sense. So for that matter, you have to have a time log to practice time management, and this is shown by this time log, though it is not much, bigger letters are not given in this, but still I'll be explaining it with the help of this. So daily time log is needed to be carried out at least once in a week or once in 3 months. Once in 3 months, this time log, if taken, can improve upon the time management. Each individual should take up this time log for managing time once in 3 months period, or a week once in 3 months. For this, you have to take care of certain things, like you have to enter your date and name. Date and name are to be entered. Then goals, which are your goals which you want to achieve daily during the daytime, they are to be listed according to their priority, according to their sequence. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 goals have been listed here. Now time for every 15 minutes is to be listed. 8, 8:15, 8:30, 8:45, 9, 9:45, like that, 9:30, 9:45. Up to 5:30 or whatsoever is your day's routine, you list the time every 15 minutes. Action is another column, that what activity you will be doing to achieve that goal. Now, in the third column, you will list the priority of the activities. Priority of the activities means certain activities are important and urgent. Some activities are important but not urgent. Other activities may be urgent but not important. And fourth activity may be routine activities. Now, how to attach the priority to these activities which you are doing? Certain activities which are important and urgent, how to identify it? Like you are
operation in which production is coming to halt, or
certain things which are not of recurring type, which are non-recurring type of activities, which are which have longer consequence as such, like you are to have a meeting with your clients or dealers as a sales manager to save your accounts, to maintain your accounts. So that may be important as well as urgent. That activity is important as well as urgent. Certain dealing with the daily dock, daily mail, that is the routine activity, catching up with the mail. Other activity which is important and not urgent, what sort of activity? Like you are to revise or review your organization structure. That is important, having a longer consequence as such, but it may not be urgent. Another activity may be important, but not urgent. That is activity like you are having some meeting with your distributors, dealers in the routine manner. So such like activities may be listed under this. Or certain activity may be urgent only. That is getting a revised ticket to your boss who is going on a tour. So that is urgent, that is the pressing as such, but that may not be important. The next column covers the comments, disposition and results. You have to give your comments in this column while entering the time log during the day, every 15 minutes of the day. In this it is listed delegate to, whether next time the same activity can be delegated to others and you should not take it yourself, because that is not that important activity and that can be carried out by others. Train others to handle it, that is you require training or others may be trained for handling that activity next time. Next time ask for his recommendations. Sometimes people are coming to you asking simple questions which they also know it, but they keep on asking you and you are answering and a lot of time goes in that. So your time may be containing that. So you have to ask the people to give their recommendations. Whenever they come with such simple questions, they should come with the recommendation. You tell me the answer. So that is a better strategy for managing the time. Next time say no. Or such like questions may be said, no, that I won't be able to deal with these things. You just read it from such and such place or you discuss with such and such person. Consolidate, eliminate and cut time or others. What activities can be consolidated, clubbed together? What activities can be eliminated and what activities can be there which can be reduced in such a manner that time can be cut in that, reduced time can be, or some other comments which you want to give, they should be noted. But it should be given very clearly, the comment should be given very clearly when you take up the activity. Even taking tea, coffee, discussion with the boss, dictation, everything is to be written. And it should be written immediately as the activity is undertaken. And if you don't write it there and then, you may be forgetting it later on, and hence there will be distorted results of the time log, and basic purpose of the time log may get minimized or defeated. Now there are some pitfalls of taking a time log. Like you may keep certain goals which are unchallenging or unrealistic, which are not achievable sometimes, or which are very easy as such, which you can achieve or any person can achieve. So unchallenging goals or unrealistic goals are set by some people. So that should not be done. We have to believe on the, or trust on the memory of ours, our memory, which is most of our time is very difficult to memorize the things. So we generally try to put the time, keep the time log, but put the activities at the end of the day or when we get the time. But by the time we forget it, and hence we should take note on the activities when we undertake it. And another is that certain activities which are undertaken may be undertaken in very great detail, no? In routine or in detail, our tendency is to involve ourselves in greater detail or routine. So we keep on commenting it here about those activities. So that is not needed. That much detail may not be needed. So these are the things which we should take care. If we see the instructions part of it, how to take up a time log in brief, then it says enter data and list daily time goals. That's enough. Enter data and list daily goals, self-impose deadlines for each goal, record all significant acts in terms of results during each 15-minute period, prioritize each action, that is routine, urgent, important, and comment on each action. That is, comments are to be given in each action. Questions to be answered immediately. Certain questions, like if you have taken the time log, what were your reactions? When you took the time log, what were your reactions? Whether you could adhere to that deadlines, whether you could achieve the targets, whether the target set were the challenging task targets, or such like how much more time you will be needing for performing certain activities, whether all the routine activities have been listed in the time log, or certain urgent activities have been listed in the time log, or important activities have been listed in the time log, urgent and important activities have been listed. So some people's time log may be containing only routine activities. This is not a sign of a good manager or good time manager as such, because mostly the good manager's time log must contain the activities which are of important and urgent nature, which may be the critical activity, crucial activities. So this is very essential as such, that prioritize each action and comment on each action. Question to be answered immediately thereafter, that I told you, those questions you are to answer, that whether, so I could take the time log in a proper manner or not. With the help of time log, we can see some profile of some people. A firm's president was managing his time like this, like activities are listed. Planning is first, reports and control second, staff meetings third, secretary dictation, telephone, civic activities, plant visits. So he could find that the time which allocated for planning, he could not, which he forecast for planning, 50% he forecast, but actually he gave 30% for that. Next time he is planning 40%. Similarly, for civic activities, he forecast only 5%, but he actually devoted 20%, which is a major gap as such. And next time he is going to plan 25% time. So if this way analysis of the time log is carried out, that will be a better method as such to, because time log activity is to be taken for improving the time management of your activities. So it is better to analyze the time log after writing it. After you write it, you should analyze it. If you don't analyze it, then there is no use of taking that time log, because that will not lead you to improve your time. So analysis is something very crucial as such, which is to be undertaken after taking a time log. And then the things which you have noticed, they are to be implemented next time. Only then there is the purpose of taking a time log is served. Then the fourth one, fourth aspect of time management, identifying your time waster. This is the chart I am showing you, which shows the identification of time wasters. Now, there are 15 of the time wasters listed in this. This is a sample of managers in 14 countries. They say this is first group, this is second group, and this is third group. First, second, and third groups are listed. General time wasters are first group, or most pertinent are telephone interruptions. Telephones are coming and you are doing something important, but you are not able to do it because people are disturbing you on telephone. How to manage it? By telling your secretary that only important people are to be, or only important messages are to be given to me. Otherwise, you can listen to the telephones and later on ask them to ring me up again at this particular hour when I'll be relatively free. Second is the drop in visitors. As I told you, that there may be some corridor wanderers, or some people come to say you hello, or some people come to pay a courtesy call, or sometimes unscheduled visitors come and they take a lot of your time. So your secretary can be trained for this thing, that only those persons who are really required to visit me, they are to be allowed. Otherwise, she can scan the visitors. Third is meetings, both scheduled and unscheduled waste a lot of time, because sometimes meetings are starting late, there may be a lot of agenda as such in the meetings, and hence that will be a time waster. So meetings are to be well planned, well scheduled, and their frequency can be limited in the organization. Crisis or firefighting, that is, when the deadline approaches, you start working on the particular project. So that is leading to crisis, and that needs crisis management as such, and a lot of time gets wasted. Fifth is lack of objectives, priorities, and deadlines. Your own limitation in setting the objectives or deciding the priorities of the activities or meeting the deadlines. You are not adhering to the deadlines, time deadlines. Then if these can be tackled by effective planning, then there may be some other group of five time thieves, they are regarded time thieves, five time thieves, which may be arising. But if they are controlled, perhaps these also get controlled, because there is a red thread as such which is running through all the time wasters. If you are disorganized, your desk is cluttered. If you are not clear of the objectives, you will be disorganized. You will be procrastinating or delaying the decisions. So fourth one is crisis. Crisis means when you involve yourself in firefighting. Firefighting means you are doing a particular thing or objective only when the time deadline is approaching. So you started that time only. So a lot of hustle is there and hasty decisions are taken and anxiety increases as such. So that leads to bad management. Closing followed by closely followed by another group of 5 time thieves. If these are there, then these will also be there. Number 6 is cluttered desk and personal disorganization. That is internal weakness of ours. That is not somebody. Some may be external, some may be internal. So this is something internal. Our desk, because we are involving ourselves in routine, and hence allowing every paper to come in, we are not destroying some of the papers which are not important, some of the papers which are necessary, they should be dealt with, some of the papers which are can be delegated, can be given to other people, and dispose of your desk is clean. But you keep on involving yourself in longer details, in larger details, and hence your desk gets cluttered and your personal disorganization takes place. 7th is ineffective delegation and involvement in routine and detail. So you don't delegate. As I told you, red thread is running. This is a common thing running. All the 15 are tied up. No? If one arises, then there will be consequences on the other. And other will also arise. 8th is attempting too much at once and unrealistic time estimates. So there is tendency in everyone that we try to manage maximum things or do maximum things. We become over ambitious most of the time. And thus our time estimates become unrealistic. We are not able to achieve those goals which are unrealistic. Then lack of or unclear communication. This is, of course, is very clear that if communication is not good, we won't be able to pass on good instructions to the subordinates. They won't be working, and hence a lot of problems, disorganization, and other things will take place. 10th is inadequate, inaccurate, and delayed information. Because we don't get proper information, right type of information, right quantity, right quality of information, or timely information, then that leads to inaccuracy or delay in decision making, and time gets wasted. Then other time wasters, which are closely following these 10 time wasters. 11th is indecisions and procrastination. Indecision and procrastination. Procrastination is putting off the decision, postponing the decision, deferring the decisions to the later date. So indecision, sometimes we keep on waiting for the more and more information, and hence we don't take decision, or we lack commitment to a point of decision. We don't want to take a decision because there is a responsibility attached with it. So we think that indecision is better, and that leads to procrastination or delay in decisions. Then confused authority and responsibility is another time waster. You don't know which authority to be delegated, which responsibility is yours, which responsibility is that of your boss. So that also sometimes creates confusion and leads to time wastage. 13th is inability to say no. Because these saying no to some things can improve upon our working. There are certain things which are not required to be answered. Certain simple questions, employees can take care themselves. So we should delegate certain things. We should try to say no to certain things which are not needed, or details you should avoid. 14th is leaving tasks unfinished. Leaving the tasks unfinished, which we mostly are having this habit that we'll do it tomorrow or we'll do sometime later. So keep it, and then when we keep on postponing like this, that, so many tasks remain unfinished, and that becomes a time waster, because next time when we take up that unfinished task, most of the things we have forgotten, and again start collecting the facts for that, so that those facts may not be available, and if available, that takes a lot of time. 15th, or the last one, is last time waster is lack of self-discipline. This is perhaps the major one and the most important one, that if we have self-discipline, perhaps this red thread get reduced, no? That get eliminated, and rest of the 14 will get automatically eliminated. So these are the time wasters, and identifying which of these time wasters are there. Actually, in handling these time wasters, people have suggested that we should take a precautionary chart as such, which says identify causes for each time waster. At least 5 internal and 5 external causes are to be identified, and 80% of the time is to be given for identifying the causes, and 20% of the time is to be given to the solutions. Solutions should also be listed. What can be the probable solutions for those causes which you have listed for each time waster? So 10 internal, 10 external causes to be listed under one column, and 20% time is to be given to the solutions which are to be listed in the second column, and thereafter you can analyze that which can be the real causes and which can be the real solution.
Viewers, you have just been shown the use of a time log for allocating time among different executive activities. Besides, the 3 major types of time wasters were identified, and the ways in which these can be handled were shown to you. In the next and the last part of the film, we will highlight the principles of time management.